Well, this is a really beautiful home. This whole Hamptons look is just so in right now. Lots of whites, lots of bright colours, almost beachy kind of feel about it.
Gary, this is my favourite house. This is the ultimate dream, isn't
it? Yeah.
The ultimate dream.
I mean, I think the reason why is, I mean, your interior design professionals and your design team and everything, all they do all day, every day, is think about how can we create the perfect home? And that's why when you walk in, you do feel like it, you want to make it yours, don't you? How important is outdoor living these days?
You wouldn't sell a house if you didn't have outdoor living.
Isn't that interesting?
It is interesting. And for someone like me that's been in the business so long, I mean, why didn't we do it in 1973 or 83 or 93? And I mean, it's all part of the dream now and it's all part of the requirement.
Okay, so everybody needs two luxury lounges. So you've got the one inside and you've got your one outdoors.
That's right.
Everyone needs two luxury kitchens. You need one indoors and one outdoors.
That's right. That's right.
And they're adjacent to each other,
yes,
too. So you can choose what you're going to do today. Are we going to be outdoors or are we going to be indoors?
That's right.
Naming a house. How do you go about naming a house?
I like to use these glamorous names. And this is a Miami. And everybody has connotations about Miami. But look, this is like being on holiday. It could have a spa, a plunge pool. It could have any sort of pool out there and anything. And you're miles away from anywhere you'd think you were.
But it's really compact, too. Look, it will fit on a decent size, a smaller block.
It starts on a 15-metre wide block.
Frontage,
and 30 metres deep. The bigger version goes up to 16 metres by 32 metres deep.
Wow, that must be huge.
It's perfectly set up. This is one of the best designs we've got.
This house, too, has the master bedroom suite at the back. Is that right?
It has, yes.
I like the idea of having the master bedroom suite at the back because if you've got guests coming through, I really don't want them looking into my master bedroom suite. Now, this house has been designed beautifully for this because you don't see in any of the bedrooms. Because the hallway leads straight into here.
Correct.
And the bedrooms have their own kind of wing away from...
The kids have got their own wing. They've got their own children's activity room.
On the home cinema room. Fantastic glass doors, because if I'm sitting in there, I can still see what's going on, but they can't hear my noise that I'm making.
And that's important, because with one-level houses, noise will move around the house.
Yeah.
So having those doors is very important to break that sound.
This configuration of the butler's pantry is really, really exciting because you're not separated from the rest of the house, but you've got everything you need. You've got a sink in there. It's away from everything. Hide all the mess. But it's not in a separate room. I don't like the separate room idea.
Well, it's not a separate room and it's part of it. But the whole idea of the butler's pantry is because the kitchen has now become part of the furniture of the house,
and
part of the living areas of the house. When you've got guests, you can go and do it in a butler's pantry. So they don't see the dirty plates and the dirty this and that and the other. And that's what it's all about, the butler's pantry.
The thing I love about McDonald Jones is you guys are all about the steel frame. Why?
Yes.
What's all about it?
Well, it is the ultimate. I mean, everything's improved over the last 10 years and steel frames will take over. It comes out of the factory straight and it remains straight.
Yeah.
There's no movement whatsoever. So that means there's no kinks in the cornices or...
Okay. Well, I mean, the plasterers would love you.
And the clients love us. And guess what? The termites hate it. They can't get their teeth into
it.
They don't eat it. And we have big termite problems in Sydney. And, you know, it's fantastic.
So now, render and materials that go on the outside of buildings. I love what you've done here. All you've done is painted... You kind of bagged the brick.
Yeah, it's called a bag and paint finish.
Yeah, I love that.
And very affordable for... the average people that want a modern looking house.
Yeah.
You can go to the more expensive rendered finish, or we can use the Hebel finish as well, which is
lightweight. As far as price point goes, I mean, lightweight brick, does it make much difference?
At the moment, we're letting people have the lightweight pretty well the same as the brick price.
Is that right? Lightweight's great because in the heat at night, it cools down really a lot quicker. So it's great for summer.
Yes.
Okay, so it's a luxury home. Can we afford it?
It starts around $249,000.
For this floor plan?
Yes, for this floor plan. You know, there's different grades you can move up, but that's very affordable in today's market.
And then obviously if you put extras in,
a lot of people, you know, will put the higher ceilings in and they'll put various other things in. It depends where your pocket is, where your mortgage is, where your money is, and we cater for everybody.
Well, mate, always great to see you. Thanks so much for showing us around.
Thank you very much, Gary. All the best.